Hey, can somebody read what it says on the task card number 3? Please read it out loud. Eric.
Play Guess My Shape game with the group. One student of the group will have a mystery shape folder, and students will take turn asking yes or no questions to help solve the mystery shape.
Okay, so I have that right here. I have the mystery shapes right here. I want to play one round with you guys, so I'm going to turn my back. Okay, who wants to be the one over there on the projector to show the shape to everybody? Emily. And so that you don't think I'm cheating and I know what's in here, I'm going to let her pick whichever one she wants. I'm not looking. Go up there. They're not all the same shape. All right, so I'm not looking, so I don't know what she's putting up there. Tell me when she's put up the shape. Okay, you all see the shape? Oh, you all see the shape? Okay. So I'm going to be the one who doesn't know the shape, and I'm going to ask yes and no questions only. Okay? Yes and no questions. I cannot ask her about stuff. She can only answer yes and no to me. Okay? So the first question I'm going to ask is it a polygon?
Yes.
Does it have 3 sides? Does it have a 90 degree angle?
Yes.
Is it a quadrilateral?
Yes.
Does it have 4 equal sides?
Yes.
No.
Oh, I heard yes and no.
No?
No?
No, not right.
No.
Has quadrilateral, has 4 sides, okay. Does it have 2 pairs of parallel lines?
Yes.
It's a parallelogram.
No.
It's a rectangle.
Yes.
All right, that took me, how many? 8 questions. The object of the game is to try to figure out in the least amount of questions that you can do. Okay? So, what I need you to do, we're going to take this one. I need you, one person from each group, come and get, hold on. I'll wait for that group back there to be done. As you finish, say your group gets the shape, I will have more shapes up here. You just come and get another folder, go back, somebody different come up and be the one who has the folder. Okay? So one person, please come up and get a folder.
No, I have raised.
No.
After like trampoline.
No.
It has 4 sides.
Yeah. That's what I told you.
But she can't tell you that. It's just yes and no.
I wanted 3 questions.
Good job. What do you call that?
So it has 4 sides. I think less than 90 degrees.
Oh, that's it. Can't be isosceles if it's not a triangle. Can't be scaly. It's not a triangle. Those are only triangles.
Yeah.
Hey, go get another one. Somebody else, go get another one. Hey, what kind of questions are you asking?
Is it a parallel?
No, wait. Yeah.
So strategically, what would be a good question that
is it less than 2 sides?
Okay. Well, let's see. I want to watch. Let's go for it.
Is it less than 5 sides?
Yes.
Go ahead and ask a question.
It said it's less than 5 sides. Is it a triangle?
Yes.
Four.
It's a triangle. What kind of triangle?
I know. I'm telling
you. You can only say yes or no. Six questions.
Is it an obtuse triangle?
Nope.
No.
Oh. Seven. Oh, I think I know what it is, I think.
Yeah?
You gotta guess if it's by size or angle.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
That's not a square.
No?
No. It has... Well, no. It's not a square.
Does it have 5 sides?
Does it have parallel sides? Yes, it does.
Does it have 5? Is it five?
One pair of parallel sides.
Less than 5.
Is it less than...
It is not a trapezoid.
Is it less than 5 sides?
Less than 5 sides? No.
More than 5 sides?
More than 5 sides? No.
4 sides! 5 sides.
Yes.
It's a pentagon.
It's a pentagon, yeah. Good job, the way you started questioning. I like that. Okay, can we all take a seat, please? Please bring back the folders. All right, thank you, Oscar, for being ready. Saul, thank you. All right, so I heard some of you were doing it in 2 questions, some of you were doing it in 3, 5, that's all pretty good. But I want to know what kind of questioning, what were the questions that were helping you strategically in this game? Jeffrey, you're one that was telling me that you got it really quick. What kind of questions were you asking? Okay, so you were kind of, you started off with polygon and then you went to quadrilateral. Why did you do that? Is there a reason? Or are you just guessing? You're kind of guessing. Anybody use another strategy that helped them kind of narrow it down and more specific to the shape that you want it? Yes, Janice? So when you asked, is it less than 5 sides, that what did that do for you? If they said yes, then what did you know was left?
4 and 3.
Either quadrilateral or a triangle. So it kind of narrowed it down, right? Anybody else do something different or question differently? Somebody else raise their hand over here. No? Nobody wants to talk about it. Jeffrey?
Is it bigger than 5 sides? Does it have more than 5 sides?
If it has more than 5 sides and they answer yes, then what do you know? It's either a hexagon or octagon because that's all that you had in your set there. Okay. Any other questioning strategies, Marissa? Okay, she went to ask if it had a right angle. If they said yes, then what did that do for you? Okay. What else could you have asked about? Do they have parallel lines, right? That would narrow it down too, to a couple of shapes. So as you're playing this game, you need to think about those kind of questions to kind of narrow it down to what shape it is. Okay? So we'll play this game again next week sometime, but hopefully you'll start to use some of those strategies. Okay, we're just about done, but what I want to do is I want to know, what did you learn today by all this stuff that we did? What was it that you learned, or what were some of the important concepts that you got today? JP?
The properties of the polygons and shapes and all that.
So properties of the polygons. Give me an example of a property or something that you learned.
Square, like four equal sides, and it turns into a rectangle and a bonus.
So it has different names, right? Good. What else? Does somebody else want to share? Jocelyn? So you learn how to question so that you can narrow it down to a different to shape. And what were you using to kind of narrow it down? So you were questioning about the properties, right? Properties. Okay. Yes, Jeffrey.
Working together in a group.
That's another thing you learned today. You work together as a group. Even though we didn't all finish our task, but we're going to finish it later. But you were working in groups. That was nice. Anything else that you learned today or something that you got? Yes?
To help each other.
Helping each other. Okay, what about math? Let's talk about math concepts. What else did you get today? Erica?
Different ways to classify.
Different ways to classify what? Shapes. And what are those shapes called?
Polygons,
right? Good. Anything else? Okay. Let me ask you some questions, see if you got it. What is the total sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral? Carlos?
360,
good. What do you call a triangle that has no equal sides? Emily?
Scaling.
What do you call a quadrilateral that has two pairs of parallel lines? This one has more than one answer, by the way. Nicole?
Parallelogram.
What else can you call it? Trapezoid, two pairs of parallel lines? Huh? A trapezoid has two pairs? Yes?
No,
yes or no? Here's a trapezoid right here. Do you see two pairs of parallel lines? I see one pair. Okay. So what else has two pairs of parallel lines? Oscar?
A rectangle.
A rectangle. What else? A square. And?
A rhombus.
Good, good. What do you call a triangle that has two equal sides? Yes.
Isosceles.
Good job. What is the sum of all the angles of a triangle? Luis.
180.
Good job. Good job. Last one, let me see. What is a shape that has six sides called, Alexis?
Hexagon.
Nice job. Okay, you can stay in for recess if you want to continue working on your poster and finish it. And if not, then you may go out to recess now.